and I did not recommend 5-3 resolution to reallocate home investment partnership program funds for fiscal years 2012, 2014, 2015, 2016, and 2017. Community Development Resolution 18366. Item number 26, resolution to amend resolution number 18272, authorizing budget provision number 2 to the Community Development Block Grant Program for fiscal year 2018 for the reallocation of home funds. Community Development Resolution 18367. And item number 27, resolution to amend resolution number 18093 to reallocate $411,697.95 in CDBG funds for program year 2013 through 2017, program year 2018, Community Development Resolution 368.
So move.
Second.
Okay.
Discussion.
Okay, moved by Councilman Valente, second by. Moved by Councilman Velez, second by Councilman Saya. Discussion, Councilman Jackson.
Twenty-five
is the CDG.
It's home money,
It's home fund.
It's for the veterans project.
So is this saying that there were money, those funds dispersed through those various years, 2012, 14, 15, 16, and 17?
No. The project started in 2004 to 2006.
Right.
The project stalled, it was home ownership. We came back to the council in 2015 asking them to allow us to convert what we've already started to move it to veteran housing. The Patterson Housing Authority was supposed to start construction. But because we're in 2014 at that time, 15, 14, the local government's accounts had to be moved forward. So they put all the money that was awarded to the Patterson Housing Authority from 24 to 26 to 2013, 2014, and 2015.
So the money that was designated in 2006?
2004 to 2006.
2004 to 2006, which is amounting to $500,000.
They actually were awarded $1.5 million to do this project in 2004.
And it stalled for what reason?
It stalled because the market tanked in 2008. It was home ownership. We came back in 2015 to ask, can we change it to veteran housing?
That was so the intent was to sell it, this house, this
yes,
these homes?
Yes, the intent to build townhouses in the fourth.
And sell them.
And sell them.
So the Patterson Housing Authority, the intent was to go into construction home and property.
The housing authority.
And we gave them 1.4, which they drew down $500,000. And the intent was to sell the properties at market rate.
Yeah, nothing that we do is market rate. It's always for the housing.
So what happens to the $500,000?
It stays in the project. They have to shift it from.
They drew it down. So was it expended?
It was expended for foundations. So they started the foundations. It didn't work out. HUD said you have to either give back the money or build something else. So we decided to build rental. And the rental was for veterans.
Gotcha.
That's number 25, right?
Did the budget change?
No, the budget's still the same. They still have 1.5. They already drew down $500,000. They have $1 million.
Which one is that one?
25.
Okay.
So is this the partnership agreement between the Patterson and Habitat? Habitat for Humanity, or is it a Patterson housing project?
It was a housing authority's project. Housing authority had money left in the account. We cannot leave the money sitting in the account, so we fund projects that's ready to move forward now, which is the housing authority, which is Habitat, and NJCDC. So we broke up the money that was available, the $1 million. We broke it up and we gave it to Habitat, into NJCDC and move the money that we have currently in 2017 to the housing authority so that they can finish the veteran project.
So the money that was allocated in 2004 through 7?
6.
Through 6. You broke that up, which was a remaining approximately $1 million, and allocated it to Habitat and NJCDC. And that was already expended?
No. It can't be expended until you approve the resolution.
Oh, this is the resolution for that bank money?
Yes.
I thought that money has a timeline.
It does, but because the project was set up in 2014, HUD has given us an extension so that we can do the veteran project. It normally only has 4 years.
My concern with these projects is the fact that it works in the provision of low-income housing, but when you actually go to the homes, they're not collecting low-income rentals. The same thing that I've been saying about all of these projects that are being done, these provisional projects that's being granted, tax credits, tax abatements, they're voucher-based projects, so...
These are not voucher-based projects.
So what is the rental?
The rent is determined by the home program. The federal government gives us a guideline every year and tells us what you can charge for rent. We can't go higher, we can't go lower, but we can go higher.
What is that rate?
It's actually provided last time, but if you want, I'll say it again.
Last time, I believe it was $1,200.
$1,250.
For what? One bedroom?
Two bedroom.
Two bedroom. And then... minus out the utilities. So the utilities, 200, the rent is $1,000.
Right.
That's how they can't go, the utilities and the rental
cannot exceed. I'm not asking what is the renter paying.
Yeah, that's what they're paying.
I'm asking what is the developer receiving as monthly rent.
That's the max they can receive. If
that's
the rent is $1,250, the utilities is $200.
Okay, I'm sorry, but. Yeah, they're not getting nothing from the government for those apartments.
Yeah, they're not getting Section 8. They're not getting vouchers. The rent is the rent. They signed an agreement that they have to adhere to the rules and regulations of the program for the duration of the time, and it's 15 years of affordability. So we tell them every year how much the rent will be.
Each year?
Each year.
Go ahead, Johnson.
Go ahead.
Well, these numbers, as you can see, and the CBC is
I can't understand the question.
The NDCDC project, which is estimated cost is $750,000 for a two-family house.
Well, where are you at, Councilman? Another 25.
About 750.
Okay, 500 to 5,000. Okay.
No, but the total budget is 750,000.
Okay. Okay.
That number doesn't sound right to me.
Right.
And as you can see, the architect, which is building 5 single family, the total budget is across 600. And I mean, if you look at the market of construction, I think this number doesn't sound.
Well, the housing authority, I'm sorry, the Habitat is building 5 brand new houses with 3 bedrooms. NJCDC is building 2 one-bedroom apartments and 2 two-bedroom apartments.
Right, but is it a two-story building?
It's actually a three-story building.
Okay. Was there 750,000? The number doesn't sound right.
That's the cost.
You said the numbers? Councilman, you said the numbers?
No, you said the overall number.
Councilman, before you, this is a house that they built in Councilman McCoy's ward, and it's for disabled adults. And I often wondered what that was going to be, and I followed when they went there, and it's for disabled adults, you know what I'm saying, and they're like in their 40s and 50s. And it costs almost $700,000, because I asked to build that house with a four bedroom, because they got 4,000, and that's all they have in there. And they have, and I look at the price and stuff, it's like almost seven, it's on East 30th Street, Councilman, and 14th Avenue, gorgeous house, but it costs almost 700,000. And they built it right there in Patterson, right there on East 30th and 14th Avenue. It was just, and I went in there, but it's a pretty house. But when you think about building a house in Patterson for 700,000, it just blew me.
I'm saying that the lot is very small, it's 25 by a little less than 100. And it's really, you were right, it's really a two-family house in a sense, in that it has a first floor, first level, that could be like a raised basement, and it's split that in half to put a single bedroom unit on two on each on the first floor. Two bedroom on the second and two bedroom on the third. My concern last time as we talked was just how much money was being put in. It's 3/4 of the project is being funded by us. And it's a rental property that will pay rent in perpetuity. And I just think that there's not enough community equity in this project for the city to commit 2/3 of the funding for a project like this. I do believe that it's something that, and I saw the memorandum that came back with regards to partnering and training, and it was insulting, the response, because the response was answering questions that weren't asked. What we were suggesting is that NJCDC partner with other nonprofits in the city, such as the grandparents, who are constantly coming here and finding themselves in a financial fix in that they have their rewarded funds, but they don't have the seed money to spend to get the reimbursement. This project, since we're putting in so much, we're putting in 3/4 of the money. It's like we own 3/4 of the property and we're getting none of the rent. So I'm saying let us give to grandparents our equity share. And maybe they're not getting 3/4, but they're getting a half. Maybe they're getting 40%, 25% of the rent in a relationship with NJCDC managing the property and have the net income have a cost sharing agreement with the grandparents so that over time they can have some seed money. What I would also suggest, this project has looked very lucrative, very simple, very straightforward, they could partner with the grandparents so they replicate the same project with the same design, same contractor in the different location, and that one maybe would be controlled in the reverse percentage between the grandparents and NJCDC in order to put them in an economic better position. If we don't develop our not-for-profits that are grassroots that are here, will never happen. And all you have is a big organization always getting the lion's share of the awards. I mean, anybody could develop this project. I could develop a project if you give me 3/4 of the money. No question about it. So for that kind of consideration, we needed something more. And I'm a little bit disheartened that NJCDC representatives were here when we had the conversation, and then I'm here tonight when we're having a vote. So I intend to ask that this item be removed. I don't know what your timing is and what you're gonna do with it, but we cannot afford to be that generous without seeing some kind of community equity sharing or return that's going to build the community.
I would ask that you amend it on the floor to remove them. I need to award the money.
Right. And we will do that. I'll make a motion to amend, yes, the resolution to
which one?
25.
25?
Correct.
To amend to what?
To remove the award for NJCDC, the $505,000, until such time that we can have a full conversation.
Have we had that full conversation in the workshop with them? Or did the vision?
They made no commitments then, and they're making no commitments now, and not here now. I think the project is a good project. I think it's a doable project. I think it could be a model going forward. I just believe that it doesn't have the community equity that would constitute the gift that the city is making.
That's correct. And we requested the workshop that they had to be in the scope of work, how much would be rent and all that stuff.
We've got that information.
You got that?
Yeah, but we didn't get the agreement to do the equity sharing or have the discussion tonight as to why. So we'll just reserve the parking reserve. If we can make that appropriate adjustment total by removing the 505 and moving it to 401.
Okay.